By this summer, Andy will be in front of the camera again for her TV comeback. This time, pitting her talents against her mother, Jacqueline Jose, who is part of the ensemble cast of Problem Child, a remake of the movie which starred Andy's aunt, Sherry Hill.
Any apprehensions about, you know, returning in front of the camera?
Right now, I haven't actually, you know, like, thought about anything yet, rather than I'm just excited to go back. It's just like, for me, my life is just gonna go back to normal, and like, I'm just gonna continue everything that I left behind, and except now that I have a baby now. So there's two of us that I have to take care of.
She'll be working with me.
Yeah.
Oh, nga eh. Sabi ko, don't think of it as a competition. I'm not naman competing with you eh. Kaya niya competed me. Sabi ko, just ano, let's just work. Ano na lang natin na trabaho. Ganun lang naman dapat hawakan eh. Huwag masyadong dibdibin, huwag masyadong maging intense.
The intensity comes from her parents, both respected actors in the Philippine movie industry. Andrea Nicole Gock was born on the 25th of June, 1990, to Mary Jane Gock and Ralph Eigenman. Both belong to showbiz families. Gock's elder sister is Veronica Jones. Eigenman's parents are Eddie Mesa and Rosemary Hill. Sister Sherry Hill and brother Michael De Mesa are equally hailed for their acting talents. Andy belongs to showbiz royalty, and like her daughter Ellie, she was also a love child. Her mother, Jacqueline Jose, met Mark Hill when the pair shot a movie together.
Believe me, I was too naive, not to know that he's married. We were in location. Tataka ko, he's been giving me flowers and etc. So I suppose, kung magbibigay ka ng bulaklak, binata ka. Pagdating ng Manila, ang dami nagsabi, oh my God, really, I didn't know. So I was trying to end the relationship, but we couldn't anymore. Nakagulo na sa side niya. There.
And then you had Andy.
Yeah.
Unlike Andy, Jacqueline was 27 years old then. She was financially independent and ready to face the prospect of being a single mother.
I enjoyed my single life. Yun ang sinasabi ko sa kanya na sayang, pero wag mong isipin si Gabriel na hadlang for you to go on, kasi naririnig niya my kwentos. My kwentos when I was single. I live alone, I drive, I live to the fullest. Yeah. I do the films that I want to do. I go abroad by the films that I've done. Mm-hmm. I used to travel a lot because of the films. Sarap ng buhay.
And you had your independence.
Oh, yeah, I was living alone.
You were supporting yourself every
day. Yeah, in 7 years, ganun ako.
Until you met Mark Hill.
Until I met Mark Hill. Yun yata yung gusto niya rin sana to have, if not, kung ano, papunta na siya doon eh, pinapayagan ko na siya this year to have her own unit, to live on her own, to try it out. But now, of course, she can't do it anymore dahil may baby na siya. Pero sabi ko, the rest, you can still go on with your dreams. Hindi naman ibig sabihin dumating si Gabriel, hindi mo na pwedeng gawin or you'll stop na from there. Andito naman ako to take care of Gabriel.
So in the case of Mark Hill, you knew what you were getting. I mean, you said you knew he was married, but then when you would have a baby, of course, out of wedlock na yon. So, what was the decision making process there?
I was trapped. The wind. I got trapped. It's a very complicated kwento about my past with the daddy of Andy. So. Okay. Ang title ko, I Got Trapped.
Okay.
On her birth certificate, Andy, just like her daughter Ellie, took her mother's maiden name, Guck.
at school, I didn't carry my dad's last name, and I felt like such an alien. Like, why am I the only one with no middle name? I didn't have a middle name. Like, it's just a dash in my ID. And it sucked because I didn't want to be different. I just wanted to fit in. I knew that I was different just because, you know, my parents didn't get married and my dad isn't there. Like, at family days, it's not every year that my dad would be able to attend. But, like, you know, with me, a family doesn't always consist of a mom, a dad, and siblings.
The young Andy grew up around movie sets, but then following in the footsteps of her parents was the farthest from her mind.
Were you exposed to, you know, the movie so early?
Just because being in showbiz, acting, has already been there. There's nothing special. There's nothing so mysterious for mm-hmm. There's nothing so mysterious about that anymore when it comes to, you know, how I see it. So I'd always, you know, look through other fields. Like, say, I guess being an artist runs in the genes, so I'm also into the art, but never really discovered my own love for acting until I was older.
Jacqueline's work as an actress kept her away from home most of the time. This instilled independence in her daughter at a very young age.
She's living with us. If I am working, nung time na nandito na in this house, she was 4. At one interview, narinig ko lang siya, naiyak ako, sinabi niya, I used to eating breakfast alone and eating breakfast again the next morning alone. Awa ako. But I couldn't do anything. I need to put her in good school, give her a good life.
So that there were sacrifices that you had to make?
A lot. Mag-isa lang ako eh. I was just alone raising her.
And the values, no, that you inculcate, you know that there are these values that she grew up with.
Kahit na in this house lang, us lang, alam niya na ang morals, alam niya ang values. I just don't know what happened. I don't want to ask her anymore about that because it happened na, and I don't want to judge her.
Once, when Andy was 10 and tagging along with her mother, who was shooting a TV drama, she thought she would give acting a try.
You could have been a child star, for instance.
But, yeah.
But wala, there was no... I mean, if you were seen in the set, the directors didn't say, oh, yung anak mo, isali natin sa eksena.
I did about 3 scenes and I bailed. Like, that was the most embarrassing thing and stressful thing that my mom had to go through because of me. Because I didn't want to finish it anymore. Oh, I was like, because... I'm sorry. I just wanted to play. I knew my friends were, you know, going to a children's party and I just wanted to come. I wanted to do my own thing. I just realized, okay, this isn't for me.
And it took another, 8 years later before you answered the calling.
Yes, actually, it was during high school, you know, like when we were thinking about our careers already, going off to college, thinking about what course I would take, and I just started asking myself what I really wanted to do. There came another opportunity in 2007.
This time, there was no turning back. When the director of the afternoon soap, Princesa ng Banyera, spotted Andy, she was good and ready.
But then I figured, you know, of course, I won't turn down an offer like that. It was such a flattering thing that they figured that I would, you know, be good for the character and it would be nice to get me to be a part of the show. So I accepted it, being that I knew that it wouldn't interfere with my studies because I'd only tape after school. So I did it. And then, eventually, I fell in love with it.
Not because your parents encouraged you or anything. Yeah. I mean, because it could have happened early.
They could have, like, made me try it out and stuff like that. But no, I actually think it was more of a self-discovery because I had to wait for years, you know, before I had realized that I've been looking for and thinking about what I want to do with my life. And all along, it's just
right there in front of you.
Yeah. I didn't even mind it at first. Like before, I wanted to be a psychologist. I wanted to be an astronaut.
I guess there was something in you that was trying to run away from it.
Just because maybe I didn't want to be everyone else in my family like that. Maybe I just wanted to be different for once.
But when she said, I think I'm going to decide on entering this business, ang sinabi ko lang sa kanya, for what? For passion or fame? Kasi if it is only for fame, money can come and go, but the passion will always stay forever. So you have to choose between the two.
Hindi ko ulit, Nay. Ikaw kasi. Po, Nay. Ito na lang.
The hit fantasy drama series Agua Bendita confirmed Andy indeed had the family's acting genes. Her portrayal of the miraculous child Agua and Bendita endeared her to the mass TV audience. Andy became an overnight sensation.
So what do you love about it?
It's the idea that, you know, it's not about really pretending, but getting yourself into a whole different person and understanding. I think that's where I got my sense of compassion and understanding. It's because I like an observing, you know? I like to look at other people and see how they are. And then when I portray a character and put myself into a situation like theirs and create a whole different person that's not me, it's amazing because it plays with my imagination. I guess acting in itself and creating that craft is also an art alone, you know?
Coming up on People.
I'm keeping my hopes up. I'm going to meet someone, or maybe I've met the one already.
Oh!
Yeah, diba? Secret lang.